This morning, we're hoping to gain even more perspective on the fight against breast cancer. Joining me now is Dr. Mina Thiranovu, a medical oncologist and MD with North Memorial Humphrey Cancer Center. Thank you so much for being here.
It's my pleasure.
And of course, screening is such an important part of this. Talk to us about mammograms versus self-exams and how women should go about protecting themselves.
So in this day and age, now, I mean, mammograms are still the best screening tools to detect early breast cancer. So what I would recommend for all women is that everyone should get the yearly mammograms as recommended by their physicians. As far as self-breast exams, there's some debate whether it really helps to detect early breast cancers or help save lives. What I would tell all women is that be aware of how your breasts feel and look so that you notice, if you notice any lumps or any skin changes or nipple changes, you can let your healthcare provider know so that the appropriate test can be done. So that's called the self-breast awareness, which is more important. So be your own advocate.
Yeah, that self-awareness is so crucial. Mm-hmm. Angelina Jolie's case, testing positive for one of those gene mutations, brought a lot of light to this, a lot of publicity. Mm-hmm. If a woman does test positive for one of these gene mutations, what should those next steps be?
When a woman finds out that they have they carry a BRCA gene, it can be a great source of emotional anxiety. The next thing that the woman should think about is, what should I do to decrease my risk of getting a breast or ovarian cancer? What we do at North Memorial is that we meet with the patient and their family members, the genetic counselor and the medical oncologist in conjunction. We sit down with the patient and their family members. We talk about the various risk reduction strategies, which means, should you do surgery? Should you do bilateral mastectomy? What are the pros and cons of that? Because surgery has its own side effects. So then we talk about, what are the other options? Can we do close surveillance with MRI and mammograms? What are the side effects and benefits of that? Can the woman take a pill like tamoxifen to decrease her risk, which can decrease your risk by about 50%? So we sit down with the patient and family members. We educate them, make sure the woman is empowered to make an informed decision based on her wishes, her choice, what stage of life she is in. So she and her family members are educated so that they can make their own informed decision.
Counseling, so important.
Genetic counseling.
Right.
That's pretty much what it is. It's a genetic counseling is the process that I'm talking about, where the genetic counselor and the medical oncologist meet with the patient and their family members and help them deal with various issues, because there's so many psychosocial issues involved. There's so much emotional issues involved. We also talk about the financial issues, as well as whether, what is the chances of your offsprings inheriting that mutation, which can all play a role in making a decision for that woman.
And we know this is just the beginning of the conversation.
Exactly.
We have many more resources on our website as well. We've posted them to links. To learn more about breast cancer, just go to kstp.com.